everybody. Welcome to Dixie's Storytime World. Are you ready to listen to Tea Veg, the story of a carrot-crunching dinosaur? Reginald the T-Rex had a fierce and mighty roar. His fierce and mighty footsteps thundered through the jungle floor. He ran as fast and leapt as far as any T-Rex could. He stomped about and gnashed his teeth as every T-Rex should. He just had one small worry, one teeny tiny thing. At dinner time, he often felt that he did not fit in. For while the other T-Rexes munched on juicy steak, Reginald the T-Rex ate crunchy carrot cake. Reginald ate broccoli. Reginald ate beans. Reginald ate bowls and bowls of garlic, grapes and greens. "It's just so yum," he told his friends. "You must give this a try," while wolfing down a massive slice of avocado pie. Mangoes, peaches, pineapples, he ate them by the dish. Banana berry shake, he'd say, "Mmm, that's so delish." Carrots, parsnips, lettuces, oh yes, he ate them too. And for a tea time treat, he munched on pea and spinach stew. "For goodness sake, what's wrong with you?" Papa T-Rex groaned. "You should be eating meat, meat, meat," Mama T-Rex moaned. "You'll never win the Tyrannolympics," laughed his best friend Hugh. "Why ever not?" asked Reginald. "I'm just as fast as you." At school, the others all poked fun. They didn't understand. "There's never been a vegetarian T-Rex in this land. T-Rexes need lots of meat. It's that makes us strong. And if you're eating vegetables, you're doing it all wrong." "Ha, ha, ha, and ha, ha, ha," they laughed at poor old Reg. "You're not a T-Rex after all. Tyrannosaurus veg." So feeling rather miserable, Reg packed his dino sack. "Goodbye, I'm leaving home," he called, "and never coming back. I want to find some better friends who'll understand me more. The truth might be that actually I am a herbivore. I'll try and do some herby things. It will be fun, I bet." But standing deep in river slime was horrid, cold and wet. He tried to do some mooing, but it sounded just like roaring. And slowing to a gentle jog was just a little boring. And when it came to foraging, Reg didn't have a clue. "I'd better find some herbivores to show me what to do." "What luck!" cried Reg. A group of them were grazing just ahead. He started stomping faster. "I'll make friends with them," he said. But as he charged to greet them and was still quite far away, the herbies took one look at Reg and shrieked and ran away. Meanwhile at home, the T-Rexes were missing T-Rex Reg. "So what if he ate fruit?" said Hugh. "So what if he ate veg? There's no one who can stomp like him or play our T-Rex games. We have to go and find him quick and bring him home again." Off they set, but pretty soon they heard a distant rumble. The cliff top right above their heads began to creak, creak, crumble. A massive rock was slowly crash, crash, crashing down the hill. The T-Rex clan was sure they would be crushed. That was until Reginald the T-Rex spotted them from far away. He galloped to their rescue and he bravely saved the day. He pushed with all his might and stopped the boulder with his weight. He held it back and set them free before it was too late. The T-Rex crew was so amazed. "Hurrah for T-Veg Reg, you're just so strong." "Oh yes," Reg laughed, "it's all my fruit and veg. Carrots help me see," he said. "Bananas give me speed. And peas and spinach help to give me all the strength I need. So though I might eat vegetables, it doesn't mean I'm weak." "Of course you're not," said all the rest. "You're strong and you're unique. Now please say you'll come home again and make our herd complete." "I will," said Reg, "as long as you don't laugh at what I eat." "We never will again," declared the sorry T-Rex crew. "And if you give us one more chance, we'll make it up to you." And so the dinos cooked a feast of vegetable kebabs and roasted squash and mushrooms, which they all agreed were fab. And then they danced the night away because they know it's true. The best thing in the world is being happy being you. The end. Thank you for listening. I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye for now.